Բարև ու բարի գալուս, ես եմ Մեդիալիկ։ Մենք սկսում ենք հարցազրույցների շարք, որոնցից յուրաքանչյուրում կունենանք հետաքրքիր հյուր մեդիայի տարբեր ուղղությունների ներկայացուցիչներից։ Եվ կխոսենք ոլորտի խնդիրների, ձեռքբերումներից։ Մեր առաջին հյուրը Նիկ Նիմինն է, ամերիկացի հայտնի յութուբեր, որն այս օրերին Հայաստանում է։ Ես եմ մեդիան վլոգինգի դպրոցիսաներին, այսինքն մեզ YouTube-ի բոլոր գաղտնիքները սովորեցնելու համար։ Hey Nick.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, you?
I'm doing fantastic, thank you.
First of all, thank you for this interview. You had to stand us for entire week answering our questions, and I think it's time to face some of them in front of camera.
Okay, sounds great.
So you are here to teach us how to be successful on YouTube, and you're talking about it in your channel as well. Why have you chosen YouTube especially? What's special about it?
For me personally, YouTube has been something, and video content in general, but really mainly YouTube has been something that has made a huge impact in my own life. And because of that, when I started making videos and I started getting feedback from other people letting me know an impact that I'm making in their lives as well, it inspired me to keep going down that path in terms of teaching other people how to do YouTube. Because like YouTube gives you the opportunity to create relationships while you sleep through the people that are watching your video content, and it gives you a chance to actually stand on a global platform, which is also a really cool thing about YouTube.
Of course, with modern technologies, it's very easy to go online, start a new channel, but one of the first things you taught us is that the goal is very important. The goal of our channels and videos. Why is it so important?
The reason it's so important is because a lot of people will start a YouTube channel and the only thing that they're thinking about is getting views and subscribers. But at the end of the day, YouTube is much more than just getting views and subscribers, because as people, we all have messages inside of us that we want to get out. We all have things that we want to let people know about. We all have knowledge that we want to share with people and experiences that we want to share with people. And the reason that it's important to have a goal is because if you're only focused on just a view count or a subscriber count, like if your goal is to spread awareness about a certain topic, then the amount of subscribers you have doesn't really matter, right? Of course, the more views that you get, you know, the more that you're going to spread awareness on that topic, but your actual subscriber count isn't tied to how powerful YouTube is as a tool to actually spread your message.
So you said that everyone has something to share. So does it mean that everyone could become a YouTuber?
Yes, I really believe so. Now, of course, you know, there's skills that you need in order to really make it work for you at the highest level. But at the end of the day, I think not only do I think everybody could, I think everybody should become a content creator, because just as human beings, like we all have different ways that we see the world. We all have a unique experience, and I think that putting that out there for other people to have a peek into is a really valuable thing.
Well, here we are, 12 new vloggers coming to YouTube, but what can we add to the endless amount of video that exists online? Is there still space for innovative and, I don't know, important content?
Absolutely. Good content. Absolutely. And the thing with content and with it being a competitive space is that because you are the person making that content, right? Because each person that makes content for the internet, again, falling back on the fact that we're all unique, each person just making content as themselves means that it's something new, right? So even if you're going into a place, let's just say beauty content, right? Because that's an easy one to talk about. So even if you go into beauty content, there's tons and tons of beauty content creators out there. But if you're wanting to make beauty content and in your mind you're thinking, you know what, I want to do this in my way, then immediately, as soon as you start making content, you're going to do it in the way that makes the most sense to you, which is going to make it unique content as soon as it goes out. And another thing that I always try to explain to people is when you look at all of the other channels out there, you look at all the other competition that you have, it's important to remember that you're not really competing with all these other channels, right? All you're doing is you're trying to grow your own audience and you're trying to connect with the people that are into the content that you're making.
Oh, that's great. It's second time you're in Armenia. And what's your opinion? Do you see any changes in Armenian YouTube, and what are like the prospects for us?
Yes, I actually have. When I was here for the first time, there wasn't much going on in terms of monetization. It was just kind of getting started, right? And now some of the people that we worked with last time when I was here, you know, they've had deals with international brands, which is great for sponsoring their videos. Some of the other people have had local deals where, you know, people are giving them money in exchange for promoting them inside of their video content, which is amazing. So basically what's happening right now is there's a transition that's taking place to where something that wasn't possible just, you know, a couple of years ago is now becoming possible in terms of being able to make money in other ways, not ads, because ads aren't available here yet, but being able to make money in other ways on YouTube is now becoming something that's more of a reality.
Well, about the monetizations, recently it has become one of the hottest topics in Armenian media community, and even some Armenian vloggers started like a petition on change.org.
I voted on that petition. Yeah, I signed the petition, by the way.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. And why is it important? What will it give us?
With the ads, it gives people a way that they can make additional money from their content. But in reality, ads are typically the lowest way that you can make money on YouTube. However, it is a way that you can make money. So because of that, it's additional motivation for people to create content, which is a good thing.
And taxation is the key in these discussions that are going on. And
sure.
Can you explain how it works? Do YouTubers pay taxes at all? And how you do that?
Yeah, absolutely. So when it comes to YouTube or any business, right? Because YouTube, as soon as you start monetizing your YouTube channel through sponsorship, through ad revenue or anything like that, it becomes a business of sorts because you are putting something out there, you're providing a service to a company in exchange for money. So then therefore you are all of a sudden a business owner. So just like if you were to sell t-shirts as an example, and you would have to pay taxes on any income earned on t-shirts, the same exact thing applies to YouTube. Any money that you're collecting from that, after a certain amount, different countries have different thresholds on exactly where you have to report. But if you're meeting those thresholds, then you have to pay taxes on those just like any other type of business.
And when talking about money, often it is much easier to reach large viewership and earn more money with, I don't know, like cheap content, easy content with sensations, fake news and so on, because
sure.
Sometimes like it attracts more attention. What are the disadvantages of taking this road, and what can we do to succeed with educational, important content?
On YouTube, there's always going to be that type of content. Right on the internet, there's always going to be that type of content. And on the internet, there's also always going to be educational, helpful, mind-expanding type of content. And unfortunately, a lot of people are attracted to the thoughtless content that you're talking about, and because of that, those videos typically, you know, will get, you know, more ad revenue and things like that. But again, it kind of comes back to your goal that we were talking about originally. If you have a goal of making more knowledgeable content and you're educating people, or you're motivating people, or you're inspiring people, then that is what you should be focused on more than the little bit of money that you're going to get from ad revenue.
And at last, what are your three short pieces of advice for like a person who wants to start his own channel on YouTube?
Start. That's the very first one, because a lot of people want to have a YouTube channel. A lot of people want, you know, they think like, oh, it'd be great to make videos. It'd be great to become an influencer. It'd be great to just put my thoughts out there and see what people, you know, think of my thoughts. And the only thing separating you from wanting to do that and actually doing it is actually picking up a camera, and you can use your phone or anything to where you actually just pick up your phone and start making videos and putting them out onto YouTube. So the very first tip is to start. The second tip is to educate yourself, because there are a lot of skills that you need to develop over time. Because of how YouTube works, it's also important to learn how YouTube works, which is why I'm here right now. But you know, educating.
Thank you for that.
My pleasure. It's been a great experience. But being able to develop the skills that you need in order to make everything work for you the best. Always be trying to learn how to improve. And the third thing is to be patient, because with those skills, sometimes when you first put out content, you know, it's going to take a little bit to actually get people to respond to what it is that you're doing, and it can take that time. So think again of what it is that you're trying to accomplish, and then keep putting out content until you can figure out how to get people to respond to the content that you're wanting to make so that you can reach your goals.
Okay, thank you again, Aradu,
thank you
for the interview, but also for the amazing workshop.
Thank you.
Thank you for being awesome. Here.